Hello everyone, welcome to this course on principle of marketing and CRM. In this video, we discuss the first unit as an introduction to marketing and the subunit, the definition and the scope of marketing. Myself, Ashok Kokate, Department of Commerce, SNDT Arts and Commerce College for Women, Pune. Welcome to all. The first one, let us start with the meaning and the definition of the marketing. The term marketing is derivation of the Latin word marketus, that is meaning the marketplace or the merchant. Generally, the marketing has become an essential part of the modern consumer's life, and the every business is totally depend on the marketing functions of the business activity. The marketing has become not only the important but inseparable part of the consumer's life, and that's why the marketing has become an important functions of the modern management in today's business world. We already know the consumers' needs and wants are endless. So to satisfy the customers' needs and the wants, that is the primary objective of the marketing. Let us start with the first definition of the marketing. The definition given by the American Marketing Association. The marketing is the process of planning and executing the conception, pricing, promotion, and the distribution of ideas, goods, and services to create exchanges that satisfy individuals and the organizational goals. As per this definition, the very clearly mentioned, the marketing is the process. Marketing is a societal process which include the planning from the idea generation of the product or the services to provide such goods and services to the final consumer. And because of that, if you see the objective of the marketing or the goal of the marketing, the goal for the organizational as well as the individual level. It means to fulfill the requirement of the each and every consumer, that is the primary objective of the marketing. And for the organizational goals, when we talking about the business, the profit is a very, very important part of the business or the goal of the business. So that's why as an organizational goal, providing the goods and services as per the requirement of the customer or the consumer, organization should earn the profit. That is the basic information of the marketing. Let us start with the scope of marketing. That is the one second very, very important point in the under this content. That is the scope of marketing. The scope of marketing has expanded to cover all functions of the business from the conceptions of idea to realize of the profit. We've already discussed in the definition of the marketing. The marketing starting from the first one very important scope, that is the marketing research. It is the first very important functions or the scope of marketing that focusing on obtaining the information from the market as well as the future market fluctuations. Based on the collection of various data, this data used to produce the product as per the requirement, as per the like dislike of the consumer or the customer from the society. That's why the marketing research function or the scope of marketing helps to organization for the long-term strategy formulation, planning and the development of the new product, exploring the new markets and expanding existing ones. So that is the first one, very important scope of marketing. The second one, the scope of marketing activity, that is the buying and selling. We already know the marketing is a very, very vast concept, and the buying and the selling is a part of the marketing. So that's why the buying related activities also part of the marketing. So which are the buying, what are the buying activity included in the marketing? We already know for the production of the any product, we need some raw material, semi-finished goods or the finished goods for the production of the final goods. So that's why the product to be manufactured or the assemble and the material required for it's largely based on the market information provided by this department. So that's why the buying is a one very important activity of the marketing. The second part of the scope as a selling, the selling is an integral part of the marketing. It involves the transferring the goods from the owners, it means the sellers, to the buyers. So that's why it involves the physical transfer of goods to the buyers along with the property rights. It means when we sold any goods, it automatically transferred the ownership from one person to the another person. It means the sellers from sellers to the buyers. So that's why the marketing is concerned about the all activities associated with the selling process. So that's why this one is the second very important scope of the marketing. The third one very important, that is the pricing. We already know the pricing is the second very important P of the marketing mix. After the marketing research or the buying of the raw material, the every organization produce the product, and after that very important time to take the decision about the pricing. It means to decide the pricing of the product, this activity also very important part of the marketing. The next one, the advertising and the sale promotion, that is the third P. We generally see the in the marketing mix, the third P is the promotion. It include the advertising as well as the sales promotion. As we know, what are the importance for the advertisement and the sales promotion in the modern marketing? So that's why if you produce the product, but if you unable to advertise it in a proper manner, or if you fail to provide your product information to the customer, there is no any demand. So that's why the advertising and the sales promotion related activities also the part of the marketing. In that, the advertising is always used for promoting the product by spreading the message through the television, radio, magazine, newspaper, internet, Windows display, we call for that the pop-up ads. So different types of media, different types of tools the business houses use for the advertising purpose. And it will definitely help to promote the sale, to increase the sale, and through they try to earn the more and more profit. The next one scope of the marketing, that is the storage, is very, very important or the essential function, because we already know nowadays every company produces the more goods as compared to the demand for the products, and there is always question of the storage of the goods. It means where to store the goods in a proper manner. This relate, it means the warehousing management, in general sense we call for that the warehousing management. So how to store, where to store, it means nearby the which places. It means we, if you divide the market into the different types of segments, so proper storage to fulfill the demand, needs, and the requirement of the customers wants, you have to store the goods or the you have to store the goods or the product in the proper manner. So activities related to the storage functions also the part of marketing, the marketing. The next one, that is the packaging. It has a very, very important part, because the packaging is not only for the safety of the product. In the modern manner, modern marketing, the packaging has a very, very important to attract the customer. So that's why the packaging and the labeling related activities also the scope of marketing. The packaging, it means to provide a container or the wrapper to the products for the safety, attraction, and ease of the use and the transportation of the product. It means when we package the product, there's the different types of, it means the different important point for the packaging. It may be to attract the customer. That is the very, very important strategy used by the business houses through the packaging functions. And the packaging related activities also the part of the scope of marketing. Let us start with the next one part. It means the scope marketing again, the remaining point, that is the distribution, the channel of distribution. We call for that the place also, because if you see the four P's of marketing, in that the last one P, that is the distribution channel or the channel of the distribution. To cater the needs of the customers widely, you have to provide the goods and services to the customer on proper time, on at the proper place, in the proper distribution channel, through the proper distribution channel. That's why the distribution of the product, this related activities also the scope of marketing. In that, there is a different types of channels we can use for the distribution. We call for that the supply chain management also, or in simple sense, if you see the channel of distribution, there is a direct marketing is there, online marketing is there, or we call for that the person to personal, personal selling, we call for that the person to person marketing is there, or the public relation marketing is there. So the different channel of the distribution are used by the companies manufacturing the different types of product. The choice of distribution channel is largely affected by the nature of product. So that's why the decision regarding the selection of the most appropriate channel of the distribution, like the wholesaling marketing, we call for wholesaling, or the distribution and the retailing, is taken by the marketing manager and the sales manager. The next one, scope of marketing, that is the finance related activities. We've already know the business, in the business, every types of business, finance has a very wide importance, very large importance, because without money, the business is not there. So that's why the every marketing activity, it may be the packaging, advertising, sales force budget, or the production, everything, all activities have to complete with the limit of the budget. It means every company prepare the budget before going to start the activity, the business activity. That's why the financial policy related activities also the part of marketing. It may be the how much cash sales, how much credit sales, how much credit limit, how to how much different types, how to prepare the different types of budget. It means the purchase budget, sales budget, or the we call mass budget also. So different types of budgeting activities or the financing related activities, or from which sources we borrow the fund, how to utilize such types of borrowed fund to maximization of the profit. So such activities we always consider as a part of marketing. So that's why the financing activity also the part of marketing. The next one, the risk management. We already know in the business, we never eliminate the risk, but we try to minimize the risk. That is the very, very important tagline under the marketing, risk management. So through the different types of tools, we can try to minimize the risk, or we try to manage the risk Under that, we can use the, it means the different types of tools to, as we call for that, the insurance is one of the very important tools to risk management. So for the, while marketing or while the selling the product or the providing the goods and services as per the requirement of the customer, so you have to, it means the transportation function is there. So in during the transportation, there is a always risk of the accident. There is, when we store the goods in the warehouse, there is a always risk of the theft or the fire. So through the insurance as a tool of risk management, we can easily manage the risk. As well as if there is a, any problem with the demand and supply about the pricing policy or the pricing strategy. So the different types of techniques used by the business houses to manage the risk, to minimize the loss. So the risk management or the risk management also the one of the very important scope of the marketing. The next one, that is the after sale services. We already know in the modern marketing, only sale of goods is not sufficient. To satisfy the customer, to delight the customer, to increase the delight net customers for the business, after sale services are very, very important. So the after sale services is last but not least function or the scope of the marketing. The responsibility of the marketer does not come to end after the final sale of the product, but extend to the provision of the services attached with the after sale. It means we call for that the AMC, annual maintenance cost. It means the annual maintenance services is there, or repairing services is there, after home delivery services, after sales services, home delivery, technical problem, customer complaint handling. The lot of after sales services provided by the different types of business houses or the businesses. So such types of activities also the part of the marketing, that the scope of marketing. The next one or the last one, the feedback from the customers nowadays, to understand the customer effectively, you have to take the feedback from the customers. So you can easily take the feedback from the customers about the product, about the benefits of the product, about the cost of the product, about the different features of the product, about the sales service from the business houses, after the complaint handling service or the customer complaint solving or the resolving services provided by the business houses. So such types of, it means the feedback, collection of the feedback from the customer, that is the one very important scope of the marketing. Other than this scope, this point, there is different other functions or the other scope of marketing also there. I already told you the transportation is there, or the branding, this is also the one very important part. It means the branding is play very, very important role in the marketing. So such types of points we always consider as a scope of marketing. The next one, very important, what you learn in this session or in this content, that is the meaning and the definition of marketing. And the second one, the scope of marketing. Thank you.